So my name is Diane Rennie. I'm the Programme Director for Scotland's Digital Strategy for Planning. I work within the Planning and Architecture Division as part of Scottish Government.
I'm Craig McLaren. I'm Director of Scotland, Ireland and English Regions in the Royal Town Planning Institute. The Royal Town Planning Institute is a professional body for town planners. We've got 25,000 members across the world. And we try to make sure that planners work to certain standards, that they have the skills and knowledge they need to run the planning system properly, and that we have a planning system which is fit for purpose.
So Craig, maybe my first question would be is, why is digital transformation so vital to the planning profession?
I think the potential is absolutely enormous, Diane. There are lots of things we can do with digital planning which we really can't do just now, and which can make a real difference to how we work. I'm thinking about things such as spatial data and how we gather data, how we interpret it and how we share it. That's really important these days, and we can do more with that. I think there's new ways in which we can engage with communities, a much more interactive way, a different way, which often reach different audiences as well, which we don't quite reach just now. I think it can just change the processes and how we work and make them more effective, more streamlined, and more easy to understand perhaps as well. And I do think what it will bring is more opportunity to collaborate across the different people, players and stakeholders involved in the planning system as well. And from that, I think we'll develop some consistency or even more consistency than they have just now. And I think it'll also help us to make better use of the resources which we have. I always think planners are a valuable resource, got a valuable skill set. And using digital planning will help them to focus on the things which are really quite important. And hopefully this will help us lead towards a sort of world-class transparent planning system where people feel as if they can engage easily with it, they can use it well, and it works efficiently.
Oh, we would absolutely agree with all of that, Craig. That's great. What would you say are the benefits of working with us as an early delivery partner?
Very excited by it. I think there's some real benefits in working together. I think we can build upon one another's strengths. You and your team have the strengths of knowing what digital is, how it works, and how you can support people to take that leap, often into the unknown, to take forward digital approaches to things. What we can do is bring in the planning expertise, know what the issues are in planning, know how planning works at the coalface, and what it needs and what digital planning can support to do that as well. I think for me, there's another thing, which is digital planning can really help us to show the value of planning, and working with Scottish Government, it allows us to show the different parts of Scottish Government how planning and digital planning can really help support them to achieve their ambitions, their aspirations, and the strategies which they've got out there as well. A lot of that will rely on spatial data, for example, and planning can help them to deliver those ambitions which they have. I'm also very pleased to see there's a longer term commitment to this. It's not just a one-off. It's a partnership over a period of time, over years. And that really shows the commitment to change. That's incredibly important for the profession to show they're being supported to do that. But it also allows us to take a really in-depth approach to making sure that this change isn't just a flash in the pan. It's something which becomes embedded in how people work and how people work in the future. So that idea of really having that in-depth partnership and that commitment from both sides, I think is incredibly important and incredibly powerful.
Great. No, we totally agree with all of that. It's definitely very powerful. Can you tell us a little bit about which areas of the strategy that your work will focus on?
Absolutely. The key focus of our work will be around trying to make sure that the planning profession and all its shapes and forms and disciplines and sectors have the capabilities to make the best use of digital planning platforms and tools. That's going to split into two different phases. We've got a discovery phase at the start, where we'll be asking those people what their skills needs are, what their capacity is, what gaps there are, what strengths there are, what the barriers are to introducing new ways of working, and what some of the opportunities are as well. And from there, we'll get a picture of the capabilities which people have and the issues which we face. And it'll also provide us with an idea of a menu of the type of tools, the type of resources and support which they need to make that step change. And that will lead on to phase two. In phase two, we'll be trying to build that menu of tools and support up and try to make sure that they work in a way which supports people in their own particular situation. So it's tailored to their particular needs. And that's probably going to focus around, I imagine, four different areas. So it's about identifying best practice and sharing that best practice and sharing the learning which we've got from that process. I think secondly, there's a bit about how we can make sure we network people, we connect them, we bring them together to share ideas, thinking, and to discuss things. I think the third thing is about reshaping practice and getting our hands dirty and seeing what things can be made to work and testing that and piloting that. And the final thing is about championing digital planning within the different places, local authorities, private sector consultancies, Scottish Government, key agencies, championing it to them, but also challenging them to an extent to try and see if there are ways in which they can see the value of embedding digital planning into how they work and changing how they work to make that more effective.
That's great, Craig. It's actually really reassuring to be working with you on this, because that does make us really feel that the programme will be a success, because we're really setting up the programme to make sure that the change does stick within the planning community. So last question was, how are the team going to approach this?
We'll try to be as tech savvy as we can, and we'll work with you and your colleagues on that. You bring that a lot of that expertise. And we'll also work with planners working in our different settings across Scotland to see what suits them best on that. For me, the really important thing in this is that we work with others to try and make sure that what we provide actually meets their needs. So we want to try and make sure that we co-design the support programme, all the different parts of that, the resources that they will need and they will use, so that they actually work for them and whatever they work in, what setting they're working within. So this idea of co-design, where we make sure people are given the opportunity to comment on things, to feedback. We learn from them. We change things where that's required. And we learn along the way. But we learn together so that we can make sure it works to best effect. We will try to make as best use as we can of the infrastructure and the connections which RTPI has. We work with a lot of other organisations and networks in the planning sector. And they are key players in this as well. So we need to make sure that they're given the opportunity to comment and connect with us, to be involved in taking it forward and to give us feedback and ideas and how we can do that. And we really need to make sure that they're connected and a part of it. The key success for me of this strategy and this action plan is that we need to make it something which is a commitment, which works in the longer term, which sticks for everyone. That relies on us all having a bit to play. And so we need to make sure that these organisations, these networks are able to be part of that so that we can make that happen.
Well, thank you, Craig. That's been great and brilliant to hear all of the work that's ongoing. And we're really looking forward to working with you, and it's going to be an exciting time over the next 5 years.
We are really excited by this. We really do think this can be transformational for the profession. So thanks for your help, and just looking forward to taking it forward. So let's get to work.